Today I'm working with Ken Oliver's Mineral Bursts, a super glimmery product that provides color and shimmer and is typically applied with a brush. Mineral Bursts can be combined with Ken's Color Burst and liquid metals. It can be washed over other products, spattered, and used as a base to build upon. Mineral Bursts are a shimmery paint that's very water-like. It's very thin-bodied, and you'll see when I open the container exactly what I mean. There is so much shimmer in the product that you have to stir it each time you're ready to use it, or shake it if the cap is closed. And I actually keep a coffee stirrer off to one side so that if I need to agitate it a little bit while I'm working to get that shimmer up off the bottom of the jar and suspended back in the liquid, I can do that. As of May 2017, there are 6 colors in the line. Platinum, which is what you see here. There's metallic saffron, metallic sky, metallic rose, verdigris, and copper. So I'm going to show you several different ways to work with the mineral bursts. I'm going to start by using it as a wash, but rather than a wash over paint, I'm going to wash it over these Marabu Art crayons, which are not permanent, so you'll see that the color does get picked up. Now I'm working with platinum. That happened to be my choice. I could have picked any of the other colors. The liquid has a little bit of color in it, and obviously the shimmer has color in it, so you just play and see what works. So I've already put a couple of colors down on here, and I'm just going to continue here with the art crayons. Now, I'm working on a surface that does not have gesso, so these are not going to smudge a lot. If you watched the video I filmed about the art crayons, you'll know that they actually smudge quite a bit more when you get them on a gessoed surface, but this is fine for what I'm doing, and you know, sometimes there's a reason that you don't want that super smudgeability. So as I turn this over, you can see, if you look in the side, see all of the accumulation of the shimmer that's in the bottom of the container. So what you'll want to do is go ahead and give it a really good shake. You want to distribute all of that, and as I said, I have a coffee stirrer kind of stuck off to one side here. You may find if you leave the jar open and unagitated for a while, you might need to come back and go ahead and redistribute that product. So I have a big flat brush, and it's actually wet, which is fine. This is so concentrated, there's so much shimmer in it, that sometimes using a wet brush is nice because it helps helps thin out some of that shimmer. So I'm just going to brush this on, and you'll see that it'll start to pick up the color from the art crayons, but I think that this is part of the interest. I like the fact that I'm getting some smudging of color and some light movement. Now, if I continue to drag this brush through there, I'm going to actually see a lot more movement of color, but I'm actually pretty satisfied with this. Now, it's going to start to curl, so I'm going to put it to one side. Let's get the art crayons out of the way. Let me pick this up and get it out of here, and then just go ahead and wipe my surface down. So that's one way to do this. Now here is, this is an artist trading card, and there's a couple of different paints on here. In the background you can see the shimmer of the Pebeo paint. These are the Dyna, the two-tone iridescent. And then the purple on top is a mix of, I want to say it's probably Dilutions and Dina Wakely. And these circles were made with the, not the repeating circles, it's the other circle design in the Impressibles plate from the Gel Press line. So I'm going to grab a clean brush now, and I'm going to come in. This time let's go ahead and grab, and I want to show you this because this is one that I did with the green. So you can see that I did the same thing here with the Marabu Art crayon, but this time I used the green, and you can see that the color of the shimmer in it has a little bit of a gold cast, and you can kind of see that in here. So you can get different effects depending on what you're doing. Now all of the paint that's on this particular ATC is permanent when it's dry, so there is no need to, there's nothing to worry about rather in terms of this stuff. I'm just shaking off to the side here. There's nothing to worry about in terms of the movement on here. All of that stuff is pretty much going to stay where it is. So as I take the cover off, you can see all of that wonderful shimmer that's just floating around in the color. So again, I want to make certain that my brush is a little bit damp. Let's get this out of the way, and I'm just going to start laying color on. Now if I think that this is too much green, if it's kind of obliterating the design too much, I can certainly come back and thin this with water, but it's just a matter of playing to see the kinds of things that you like. So this is Mineral Bursts used as a wash over the top of something. Next I want to show you how you start with a wet layer of Mineral Burst as your base, and there's a couple of different things that you can do to it. You've probably seen our video about working with the Color Burst in liquid metals. So if you want to take the shimmer to the nth degree, rather than working with a wet base that's just water, you can work with a base that's the Mineral Burst. So I'm going to take the metallic saffron, I'm going to agitate so that all of that product is suspended in the liquid and it will be there for me to use. All right, take the cap off. So in order for the powders to work really well and for the bursting to happen, it's important, let's just slide these out of the way, it's important to have a nice wet base. So you can see that I've taped, this is one of the Strathmore 6x6 watercolor artist tiles, and you can see that I've got it taped down. The reason for that is twofold. Primarily, it's because this much liquid would make this paper curl. Even though it's 140-pound high-quality watercolor paper, there's a certain amount of curling that's going to happen. The tape prevents that. The other thing that you might notice, you can see that I've taped about 1/4 inch inside the edge of the artist tile all the way around, and that's deliberate. When all is said and done and this is dry and I peel the tape off, it's going to provide a white border that I can come back and do something with if I want. So again, I'm just going to agitate this. I need plenty of liquid out here. I can always add water, and I have a spray bottle of water handy. So I've picked some coordinating colors in the Color Burst line. I have Merlot in orange, and in the Liquid Metals line, I have Metallic Mandarin. So I'm just going to spritz a little bit of color in here, and you can see that bursting that happens. How awesome is that? The key really, though, is you need to have enough liquid on there for the reaction to happen. Now, I tend to like subtle, so I'm probably not going to do much more than this. I kind of like the way that this looks. I'm going to add a little bit. I don't know why I'm shaking the Color Burst over to the side. I'm just shaking dry powder. So now I'm going to add a little bit of Merlot, and I'm just going to ever so slightly. I'm kind of hitting the bottle or tipping the bottle and shaking without really squeezing the bottle too much. If you want more powder to come out, you have to squeeze for that to happen. So I've got Merlot on here, but I'm not seeing a lot of reaction. I like the movement that I'm getting. I don't want to spoil it too much, so I don't want to go too far with this, but I have just, this is just a Ranger Mister bottle with some water in it, and you can see that I can cause some other things to happen. Now, I like this kind of swirl thing that's going on, so again, I'm going to leave it alone. Now, the thing with this is, what I need to do is, first of all, I missed getting to the edge right there. What I need to be able to do is dry this or walk away, and since this is in the middle of my area where I film, I'm going to have to dry this. So in the next segment, I'll come back and I'll show you this. And so now I am shaking something that needs to be shaken. This is Liquid Metal in Metallic Mandarin. So I'm just going to drop a little bit on here. Again, you see that kind of bursting thing that happens. You can see the spread of the color. If I wanted to accentuate that, I could come back with water and I could mess with that and get it to move. But because I like the rest of this, I think I'm just going to leave it alone. I do want to put some here in the center. I got some really interesting movement going on in that area where it got dark from the Mandarin. Now, the interesting thing about Color Bursts, even though none of these names suggested blue or green, you can see the color in there. That's part of the magic of these things. In order to get a color, there's typically a mix of others in there. So to get something that's kind of Merlot-y, you're going to need some blue to get that red over to the kind of winey side. So that's something interesting that you'll see. Again, this is not a mistake. This is part of the process. I think I'm going to put another drop here, a couple more there, and I'm probably going to call this done. So I'll dry this, I'll clean it all up and come back, take the tape off so that you can see that framed area, and then I'm going to show you this same process, but instead of a water-based product like the Liquid Metals or a powder like the Color Burst, I'm going to come back with alcohol ink. I'm set up again in much the same way as I was the last segment. I have a Strathmore 6x6 watercolor artist tile taped in place. I'm going to get that same roughly 1/4 inch frame all the way around. I'm going to work with metallic saffron again, and I've got 3 colors of alcohol ink. Doesn't matter if you use Ranger, if you use the Copic, various refills. But before I take the step and actually start to demo this, this is what came from the last segment that you saw me do. I've captured all of the patterning because I didn't move this piece. I dried it in place and then I took the tape off and picked it up. None of this moved. This is basically what you saw in the last segment. It's all kind of frozen in place, if you will, because I dried it in place. So this is what we're actually going to create this time. Now, I used the platinum mineral bursts on as the background, which is why it's white. But you can see that I've got these dots of color. That's alcohol ink. So you're going to get a couple of things that happen. The first thing is that you're going to mix an alcohol base with a water base, so there's some unpredictability that goes along with that. And if you look at the back, you can see that what happens is when the alcohol ink sinks through the liquid, the water that is the mineral burst, it'll grab on here. It doesn't make any difference. I'm just actually showing you what happens. So I'm going to start out in much the same way. I'm going to shake the heck out of the mineral burst so that I get all of the shimmer distributed in the liquid, and you can see that it's up now and it's all in there. So I'll go ahead and take the cap off. I'm going to bring in that same wet brush because, again, I want lots of liquid. For this to really work, you need ample amounts of liquid. And then the last thing that I'm going to do, I have some alcohol in a sprayer. It's one that I have marked with a piece of green tape so that I don't ever mistake it for water. I'm going to either spritz or I'm going to use the pickup tube, and I'm just going to drop some alcohol on here because that'll create some interesting bursts too. All right, so there's a little bit of color coming in there. That's just from what we did in the last segment. I'm not too worried about that. So I think we've got enough product on here. If we don't, then I can always come back and I can add some water. So I'm going to start grabbing alcohol ink. This is a Copic Various Refill, and you'll see the bursting. How awesome is that? You can see all of the mineral, all of the glimmer get pushed to one side all the way around as the alcohol ink drops on there. So this is really an interesting technique. Now there's a big puddle here, which is why I got this gigantic reaction. The more liquid there is, the bigger your reaction is going to be. Let's come over here. So again, I've got a lot of liquid on here. I'm getting all of this wonderful movement and reaction. Let me come in with the next color. This is, again, another Copic. I'm just going to go ahead and drop this on here. Now, I'm not trying to make great art. I just want to show you the technique so you can see how this works. And then the last thing that I'll do, although I got to tell you, I do like this, the last thing that I'm going to do is come in with a little bit of Aqua. This is a Ranger alcohol ink. A little bit more control here, but watch what happens when I drop it in here. I get different brands, so you're going to get a little bit of a different reaction, but you can see the water, the liquid of the liquid metals, come back right over the top. So depending on how much of anything you've got on there, you're going to see some different reactions, and that's just part of the joy of playing with this. So now I'm going to grab, again, here's my spritz bottle that's marked with green. I'm just going to go ahead and spritz a little alcohol on there, and how awesome is that? So now I've broken up the alcohol that had started to move around. Less of that will happen here because there's not as much liquid, but you can see that you can get these really interesting effects. So again, before I can do much of anything else, I need to come and dry this, and I will show it to you in the next segment. The last thing I want to show you is how you can spatter this. And there's one other thing that, there's one other thing that I want to show you, which, sillily enough, is just done by dabbing some color on with a coffee stirrer. Okay, last thing, super easy, super shimmering spatters, just the mineral bursts and a fan brush. But before I show you that, here is the piece that I did in the last segment. Again, I really like this white border. I like the way the alcohol ink kind of fractured in spots when there was a lot of liquid on there. And there's nothing not to like about these mineral bursts. With all that super shimmer and glimmer, they're just a really nice product. So all I'm going to do is put a little bit. Let's get this shaken so I've got all of the good stuff distributed in the liquid. Whoops. I'm going to take my fan brush, put it in there, maybe a little bit more, and I'm going to stick out my finger, take my brush, and tap it on there. Now, when you have only a little bit of liquid, the tendency is that you get littler spatters. When you have a lot of liquid, you can see that I'm getting much bigger spatters. So that's how you regulate the size of the dots that you get. Lots of liquid, big spatters, much less liquid, really small spatters. That's how easy that is. All right, so let's slide this out of the way. And for this last thing, I'm probably just going to go ahead and use green again, although I have a brush that still has a fair amount of yellow in it, but that's all right. We'll just let them mix. I've just got tape on the back of this so that it doesn't curl on me. It kind of holds it in place. I'm going to grab, I'm going to grab the mineral burst that's right here on my table. I'm just going to lay a thin wash on top, and then I'm going to take a coffee stirrer. I'm just going to stir it around in there, and this is just ridiculous. Oops, well, that's a mess. This is just ridiculously easy. You just pick it up and set it down, and it makes dots. Now, there is nothing revolutionary about this other than the fact that it's just another fun way to play with the product and to create various effects with it. And so this is what I did. I did this with the metallic rose. like I said, there's nothing revolutionary here, but when you're looking to try something a little bit different, or when you want to add kind of a different effect, you want to step away from your norm, then that might be the way to do it. And then, so this is the one that we did earlier, or I did earlier, before I started the film, and you can see that I came in with a pit pen and just added some embellishments. Now, I could take that a lot further, but for now, it's off to a good start. So, Mineral Bursts from Ken Oliver, they're a really nice product. You can see how heavily pigmented they are. You can see how much of the glimmer there is in there. And with six colors to start with, there's nothing not to like here.